Let's put our data collection and graphing skills to the test with a pendulum lab. A pendulum is a weight hung from a fixed point so that it can swing freely backwards and forward. The motion of a pendulum can be used to power a grandfather clock and can even be used to prove the rotation of the Earth. The purpose of our lab is to determine the graphical and mathematical relationship of the factors that determine the period of a pendulum. By experimenting with a series of variables that may be affecting the pendulum's motion, we can determine which variable actually affects the pendulum's motion. To understand these variables, we need to look at our independent versus dependent variables. Independent variables are the variables that we manipulate. We change them. In this lab, you'll be exploring three different independent variables: the length of the pendulum string, the mass at the end of the pendulum, and the amplitude, or the degree from which the pendulum is released. Our dependent variable, or the variable that we are recording and measuring, is the period. The period of a pendulum is the amount of time it takes for one complete cycle, or for the pendulum's mass to return to the initial position from where you let it go. That's one full left swing and one full right swing. In order to examine the mathematical and graphical relationship between these independent variables and our dependent variable, we'll be using a FET simulation. Once the FET simulation page is opened, click on the big play button. That'll open the pendulum simulator. In the simulator, we can manipulate our length, mass, and amplitude, our three independent variables. To measure our dependent variable, the period, you need to select the photo gate timer. Once the photo gate timer is going and the pendulum is swinging, you just need to hit start. It does not matter where your pendulum is located at the time, it will collect data on one full period. We'll be testing whether each of these three independent variables, length, mass, or amplitude, impact the period. When measuring the length, you'll change the length of the string five different times. Those five lengths are recommended in your packet. Record the period in the data table each time, and then graph length versus period using graphical analysis. For each additional variable, you'll do the same thing. Change the mass five times, record the period at each mass, and then graph mass versus period using graphical analysis. The same for amplitude, the degree at which you release the pendulum from. Change the amplitude five different times, record the period at each amplitude, and then graph amplitude versus period using graphical analysis. All manipulations of length, mass, and amplitude are given to you in your data tables, right next to where you'll record the period for each manipulation of your variable. Once you have graphed all of your data, you can start to write the mathematical equation for the variable that impacted your period. Two of these variables will have no impact on the period. One will either increase or decrease the period. That is the variable for which you want to write a mathematical equation. Once you have your equation, you can move on to answering those post-lab questions, either with your group in class or independently at home.